fundamentally, we invest in companies that are 5 to 15, maybe even 20 years old, that have been around for a while, done a lot of work, and maybe have hit a temporary, in our opinion, temporary hit bump in the road. And Wall Street has decided that they're not willing to wait around while the company gets turned around for the 1 to 3 years that it might take. We don't mind that. That's when we invest.
But, you know, there's always been one very constant theme in picking a company that we're going to do some work on. We have to find it interesting. And, you know, so we're curious people by nature. We want to hear cool, neat stories. We want to see the substance behind them. And our portfolios, you know, reflect a lot of the transformational opportunities that we occasionally see in health.
Is there anything that you saw in the last couple of years that really changed the way you wanted to look at a company or a sector? Was there a specific company that you can point to, an example or a technology that you saw that came out that said, boy, you know, we've got to look at liver disease because these guys are coming close, or this new technology is something we've got to look at, sort of the way the human genome when it came into existence or high throughput screening came through? Is there something that you saw that sort of really intrigued you over the past couple of years?
Technology offered us the Replicon assay, which was the first time that we were able to go outside of a very poorly predictive animal model and start to not identify whether we have a drug, but whether or not the chemical that we're putting in there can actually impair viral replication.
It's just shocking to me how many people come to this conference and how many people are involved in life sciences. I think I read the other day that there's 8 million people in the United States that are involved in life science.
What are the sort of things that encourage you to want to take another look at a company or take a chance on that company that doesn't yet have the revenues, or will you not?
I'm really looking for companies that are developing products that are going to make a breakthrough in an unmet medical need. And when I say unmet medical need, diabetes is an unmet medical need. I mean, they're just cholesterol, blood lipids is an unmet medical need. We've got solutions, but they're not perfect. One. Number two, I'm interested in companies that have, in general, particularly on the drug side, that have engines that will continue to generate multiple products over time.
Looking at specific stocks, the analyst is going to go online and he's going to take some. There's obviously smaller companies that I love that you'll be hearing about from me probably on CNBC, etc. But sticking with some bigger ones right now, my personal favorites for the upcoming year, I'll certainly go down online on this one. I think Gilead, which made close to a new high again, I think it's on its way to 125. I happen to like it a lot. I happen to be a big fan of ISIS. And I think on a private side, a company that's poised to become a big hit when it goes out, because I've got a lot of confidence in the management team particularly, and their ability to show depth and diversity of technology and applications is Intrexon.